EA Sports. It's in the game. Boom! They put a big hit on him, and he lets it fall out of his hand.
I'm really, really out for blood this time, look. I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Gonna tell a friend to tell a friend. They say success is the best revenge. Heard they was sleeping again, say it no more. This is a rude awakening, kicking the door. Back and I'm better than ever before. Don't get it mistaken, I'm ready for war. I see the ops and I'm up in the score. I catch a and jump in the course. Follow the core and I'm back to the morgue. Take the sheet off and I keep some more. When I am done at the scene, I won't leave anything. You won't even know who was involved. Don't let me do it, cause I overdo it and do it till I cannot do it no more. All of the data's, I'm proving them wrong. Back with the classic, I know it's been long. Had it was missing me while I was gone. I smell the victory, back up on type, and it's where I belong. Like it ain't me, we making history. Fall through the misery, weather the storm. Can't let them get to me, no weapon form. Should prize, but I'm be all over my roster. Still got options, I keep a right on the dresser. Next to the Oscar, applying pressure. Somebody stop us. Woo! Applying pressure, somebody stop us. Running my concert, go need a doctor. Go need a doctor, go need a what? I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my head. Gonna tell a friend to tell a friend. They say success is the best revenge. I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my head. Gonna tell a friend to tell a
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Chicago Bears and the Dallas Cowboys. Just about time to rock as toe gets ready to meet leather. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Play one, and Prescott to the air. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Ferguson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A good start. One play, 10 yards.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Prescott on first down. Able to hit his target, Lamb. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Dominique Robinson, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. But defensively on the previous play, they gave up a pretty good chunk of yardage, but right there, they got a good portion of it right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They've got to figure out a big call.
Oh, Prescott stripped. points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as he'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. And the Bears now with a first and 10 at the 20. They'll start this drive out on the ground, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package, and that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
And I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and 1. On third down, Herbert. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction. But so much for picking it up on the ground on third down. Third play of the drive, and this defense showing strong early.
I wonder how much of that was scouting. I wonder how much of that was a gut feeling like, okay, let's just go ahead and sell out here and get after them, thinking they're going to run the football and stuff them early, because they've now set the tone. They've set a precedent right here that if you're going to try and run the ball against us, it could be hard going throughout this game.
He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. And he is going to have the Bears first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive.
Well, it all came together on that one, didn't it?
Big time throw on fourth.
Now that had to feel good, didn't it? Taking that type of a gamble there and making it pay off. What a throw.
And tough as a receiver, because no matter how perfect the pass, you know it's fourth down and you gotta convert.
A little bit of extra pressure, but he overcame it.
We're scoreless after 1. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 41. On first and 10, it's Herbert. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5, to about the 39.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
From the 39, Fields. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 28. 11 yards for number 11.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Here's a give to Herbert. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Herbert once more. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Well, that's not an easy play for a defensive end because most of his responsibility has him getting upfield and working. But how about his vision to see where the play was going? Crashed down inside and tackled him for a loss.
Throw left side, taken in by Claypool. Touchdown, Bears! Chase Claypool from 17 yards out. And the Bears post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Had the option to hand that one off or run it himself, but instead, a really easy quick pass.
I like the way they made a decisive decision and got it right to the receiver. One move later, he's in the end zone.
No, oh, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there, and this will stay a six-point ball game. The Bears send the kicking team out there, and they will send this one away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. As we eke closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
On second down, Elliott once more, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
They'll send a receiver here in motion right. They'll bring a receiver in motion left.
Let's go, defense. Our time. It's our time.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack. Dominique Robinson. That is now two sacks for him here in this first half.
He continues, Charles, to be under constant pressure, and these sacks, they're starting to pile up.
And if they want to have a realistic chance in this one, they've got to change their blocking assignments. They've got to do a better job to keep him upright. If he's going to be on the deck constantly, they've got no chance to win this game.
And that is incomplete. On the coverage, excellent there downfield, and it leads to a fourth down. Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line.
Absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
The last run got six, now second and four. Fields going to get that out wide to Mooney. And he's got room. A big play there just before halftime. 85 yards. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
So that's about as long a non-scoring play as you're going to see from inside their own 10 to first and goal. A handoff for Herbert. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Another carry for Herbert on second down. And this time he is in. Khalil Herbert in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bears would extend their lead here just before halftime. Boy, that was a quick drive. The passing game set it up, and then the running game finishes it off.
And how about how few plays it was to get it done, but they threw it downfield and it pounded into the end zone. And as a former defender, I can tell you, it hurts just a little bit more when they run it into the end zone instead of throwing it.
So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with 5 seconds to go, this will likely be our final play. And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. Oh, he's got a little daylight. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And the half will begin with a touchback. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box, establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going so they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But it looks like they're ready to go.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Now Fields. He hits Mooney going across the middle. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. They'll set up the screen to Herbert. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Nice third down conversion and even 20 yards.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens because if he starts feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness against them.
And the Bears are going to have a first and goal as he's able to take this inside the 10 to the 8.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
Second down and goal. Fields. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. The tank, DeMarcus Lawrence with a sack.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
Yeah, he's got it. Touchdown. Chase Claypool with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bears take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, that's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock too with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Now the point after try for Santos. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 43 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball four times. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end, and he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we've played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. On third down, Elliott.
On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40.
It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
On third down, it's Prescott. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page,
quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
And he is going to have the Cowboys first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters. And this deficit is going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where, as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
Elliott going to get it again on second down. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. That leads us to a first and goal. It's a pickup of eight.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2 yard line. They'll try to run it in with Elliott, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1 yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. Here's Elliott. And Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky. This defense continues to be good on third down. I mean, they haven't allowed a touchdown offensively. Are you saying, let's go for this? Let's try to get it in the end zone.
I don't know about that because of what you just described. They've been so good, and they don't give up the big play that you would expect in downs 1 through 3. Why should fourth down be any different?
True.
You might want to go ahead and kick the field goal and see if you can figure out something else as this game moves on.
Running with Elliott, and this time he is in.
Yes.
Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. So fourth and goal, their head coach gave that offensive line one more chance to punch it in, and this time they were successful.
They certainly paid off the coach's confidence, didn't they? And how about the fact that they stayed with the ground game? Because a lot of times in that situation, partner, we see teams try and roll the quarterback out, give him a little run-pass option, and treat it like a two-point conversion play. In this case, they went with a little bit more power and got it done.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. That one looks like he'll throw here. And it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football. Well, in all likelihood, this ball game's still over. I mean, even with the interception, two-score game, they need a miracle.
Curious decision to even throw the ball in that situation, but maybe they saw a stacked line of scrimmage and said, hey, it's better to try and throw it than to try and run against it. In any event, I think you're exactly right. Now, the other team can pad their stats, but I don't think they're going to win.
Yeah, but still, don't change the channel just yet. A first down carry by Elliott. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
And now the focus is really clear. They need to get that first down and either get out of bounds or maybe use one of those timeouts.
They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. Here's Dak. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Dominique Robinson in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
Well, this has to count as a great team effort today, but this man, he's been at the center of all of it. Really special day for any defense to have this many sacks in a game. Even more so for this player. One of the best individual efforts of the season.
So this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done. Really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball. You're handing out multiple, although I set you up by saying game balls, plural. Yeah,
But I like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent, like, the best player of all that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people. I thought I was the only child.
You get a game ball, and you get a game ball. Game balls for everybody. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Big D.